we're going to bring all the high expectations and all the cultural aspects of physical education. We're going to bring it to the inner city.
We're going to work round one. This is where the mental part comes in. Good form, squatting below, getting the hip below the knee, all the little things.
If you build trust and you have high expectations, kids will step up to the challenge. You'll see a purpose to everything we do in regards to putting kids, to taking them out of their comfort zones, but helping them break through that. It's no fear and no embarrassment. That's what we're trying to get at all times.
We're going to work very hard. You're going to see a lot of sweat on this floor here today. Show them why you're the best in the city right here. Don't compromise your form. Don't compromise your form. Think of that one word motivation you chose in the beginning of class. Make that be the only thing you think about. Don't think about fatigue. Don't think about how hot it is. You just think about that one word and let it get you through this team time that we have here.
So the ninth grade is about building culture. It's about building that confidence. It's about getting them going. Not only can we do the exercise, but we could actually take people through the exercise themselves.
He needs some motivation. Excuse
me.
How many do we
have? No!
We have a lot of stories, especially our young students, once they get involved with our program. They go home and they try to get mom or dad or cousin or aunt or whoever involved. They say, look at what I've learned here. Look at these things. Let's try to change our lives a little bit with what we do.
Are we motivated?
Yes, sir.
Are we motivated?
Yes, sir.
Bring it in on three, Bulls. One, two, three,
Bulls.
One cool down now. Let's go.
One of the things I think that's an issue, I think, in our country is that I think you have academic teachers that are held here and physical education teachers that are held here, and we don't do that. I mean, we're all held to the same standard here. Once we prove that we're going to take numbers from the improvement rate, the growth rate of their physical numbers here in high school, and associate that with college graduation rate, I think it's going to be kind of the proof in the pudding that everybody needs, without a doubt. Instruction time is the most valued aspect of what we have here. So we have a system, a greeter system that exists that means that if we were to walk into a classroom at any point in time, that it wouldn't disrupt instruction that's going on. And so with that, that allows for the teacher to never to get off track with their own particular lesson plan. Hey, Justin.
How's it going? All right.
Morning.
Hey, sir, Mr. Oplander.
What we're doing is basically learning about the post-war effects.
Right now, working on going over classes and being prepared for a clip.
This is our algebra classroom.
How do you like the 3 years here so far?
It's been a challenge. So it's something you definitely have to get adjusted to.
What I like is that they actually push you, and they push you in the fact that they don't have to hold your hand as much. I like the burpees.
The burpees? I've never heard anyone say that. That's awesome.
Here, it kind of like introduced you to, the flexibility aspect, the weight training, and what I knew is real endurance now.
Thank you, Mark. We'll let you get back.
Good luck with everything.
We'll see you third period, okay?
We're going to do handstand push-ups.
Yeah,
that's what we're going to work on. Have you guys done those at all yet?
Yes, sir.
All right, I know some of you haven't, all right, and that's fine. So I'm going to go through the progression that we're all going to do together.
A lot of times our kids will go into college, mm-hmm. and we worry about the persistence rate because
right.
they show up and they don't have anybody to bond with.
Mm-hmm.
Our kids are 90%, 93% minority.
Right.
When they go, they just don't have anybody that they look like, right?
Mm-hmm.
But we think that if they have something that they can connect with kids from Iowa and Maine and all over the country, they have something like CrossFit that they can connect with, and then they can build a community off of that, that will really help our persistence rate.
You can pretty much guarantee that over the next 5 years, every university is going to have some sort of CrossFit club or a student-led group. And we're encouraging our kids to go there and be a part of leading those. If it's not already there, go start a CrossFit club.
Key points, teaching points. What are you going to focus on for clean? To the class. What are some things you gotta focus on?
Chest up, you gotta get your hips back.
We're studying in the 12th grade, we're studying the level one certification guide right now. I mean, they're creating quizzes on it, they're creating curriculum on it, and we're actually gonna take a test at the end of the year that I think would be very similar to what the on paper test would be.
Then you wanna squat all the way back, put your butt out first, chest stays up, and that thrust.
I'm not worried about somebody making fun of me. I'm not worried about how I look when I work out. I'm not worried about any of these things. I know that I'm going to be accepted for the amount of hard work that I put into what I do.
You make a promise to yourself and everybody here that as soon as you step foot on that college campus, you're going to go around saying, what's your Fran time? Where's the CrossFit gym? Where's the club? And if it doesn't exist, you're going to start it. You with me on that?
Yes, sir.
And then after that, 4 years later, we're gonna graduate, and I wanna see 10 good burpees on the stage when you do. All right? Here we go, let's go.